Hello, hello everyone. How are you? This is a very special day for us because we have a very, very talented and enthusiastic and a passionate author with us, Dr. Ratna Gosen. We will be talking to Dr. Ma'am about her book writing journey today. This interview is going to be a part of our butterfly effect. Interviews where we tell everyone that butterfly effect means when a butterfly flies or waves its wings in the one corner of the world, the effect is felt long distances and the effect is felt everywhere in the world. So it has a cascading effect. So we are conducting this series called Butterfly Interview. And then we have a very, very talented, very, very passionate author with us. We will be spending some time with her today. Before we move ahead, let me introduce a bit about her. There are many things to tell about her, but I'll be telling only few limited required things about her, which are very, very important. Author is an alumni of Kakatiya Medical College for MBBS. An alumnus of Gandhi Medical College of Postgraduate in Pathology. And she has worked in the various posts from registrar to senior resident and the consultant pathologist, and majority of the experiences shared from the government service. She has most of her experiences in government sector. The author has short corporate experience also, but then she moved to her current job, that is the super specialty ESIC hospital. She is heading the Department of Pathology in Sanath Nagar, Hyderabad. She was born in 1980 in one of the villages of Andhra Pradesh. She's originally from Andhra Pradesh and now settled in Hyderabad with her family. She is pursuing her career in Hyderabad. She has more than 12 years of experience in the field of pathology, and she is a very, very passionate writer. So welcome, ma'am. Thank you very much for joining us today. We welcome you.
Thank you very much, sir, for your kind introduction.
Thank you. Thank you. You want to add something to the introduction if I have missed anything?
Nothing, sir, you have covered many.
Okay. So, ma'am, when we are talking about your book, can you first tell what this book is all about? What is the topic and subject of this book?
As the title says, the compound microscope, many people think it's some pathology related book, but it is actually an autobiography of an author who is a pathologist.
Huh.
So with a little bit of introduction to my childhood, my schooling and college, majority of the experience what I shared in the book is from my professional experience.
Okay.
So
Let's show
that
you.
it'll.
Let's show your book to the audience.
Yes.
If they have not seen it, let them see. You have a copy?
Yes, I do have.
Wow. A compound microscope journey of a pathologist.
Yes.
Fantastic. Beautiful. So, ma'am, why did you think of writing this book? You could have written on any topic. You are master of many topics, I'm sure. Why you decided to write on this topic particularly?
I wanted to dedicate it to my parents because whatever I am today, it's all because of my parents, especially my father and mother. So each of them, they have did their what's it, beyond their capacity to make me what I am today. So when they are in their full senses and when they can appreciate, and I wanted to dedicate that book to my both the parents, and I wanted the whole world to see my parents' hard work and efforts. So that was the main motive behind writing the book.
Of course, of course. Our parents always take a lot of trouble in bringing up in our upbringing. Then, when they are sending us to good schools, good colleges, when they are supporting us to begin our career, and then obviously they are helping us stand in our own fields and then grow in that field. So without their blessings, it is totally not at all possible. So for how many days you were thinking of writing this book?
Quite some time I was thinking, mm-hmm. but because I have many times online I have contacted you to attend this offline programs also you had. Many time I have registered for the programs, but I could not attend it. But when I have seen WhatsApp chat showing that it's going online, then wow, I should not miss this opportunity. So I have grabbed that opportunity and I have registered with you people. So that's how it has taken into it. It's you people who had made it possible. Otherwise, I would have been thinking it for years, few more.
We only supported you, ma'am. That was our job. Our job was to support you, help you, motivate you and encourage you. The main work was obviously done by you.
Yes, sir. But it was only in the back end. Whether I'll be able to write. See, becoming an author is not an easy job. Of course, it is easy under somebody's guidance. But we will have so many queries inside our mind, like whether I'll be able to write the book. Writing a book is like looks like a huge task. So, but I think you people has made it very, very simple. Now I feel anybody can write a book.
Now,
so
of course.
That was the advantage of joining Superfast Authors.
Thank you very much for trusting us, ma'am. At the same time, when you decided to write your book, when you decided to publish your book, you could have gone to any publisher. There are many publishers available in the market, but why did you decide to work with Superfast Author only?
You have it's main the matter of trust, and what exactly I have liked in you is there is a fixed a strict schedule a discipline in this, and you're devoted to complete it within the target time. So, and you follow it up every day. We have a group where exactly we have to report it every day, like how many words you are committing to write it down today. So that competitiveness and the mentorship of Kailas sir and all those things, if you're not able to finish it off within the prescribed time, so you yourself will feel, so am I lagging behind? So all those things, we are structured in such a way where you have to complete the book process within a specific period of time.
Great. And that motivated us to work with us.
Yes.
Great. So, in number of years, if we talk in number of years, how many years this idea was in your mind that I should be writing a book?
I've been thinking about it for the past 3 or 4 years.
Uh-huh.
Whatever the journey, because I am the head of the department, so non-teaching. I'm not from the medical college or something like that. So people will come to their retirement, but they will not get any opportunity what I got in the period of 10 years.
Right.
It was a very major change what a pathologist can encounter in their life.
Mm-hmm.
So all the events, what I got and how I have established one by one, all those things will definitely help the future generation of pathologists. Like when she can do it, why not we can do it? So
they can take motivation from you.
Yes.
Wow. So now when you are a published author, now when you have a book released under your name and now people know you as author, do you see any difference when people look at you that previously they used to look at you when you are not an author? How was the experience or the treatment or the image in their mind? And now when you have become an author, does anything change? Did anything change?
Definitely. It's another feather on the cap. Scientifically, yes, I'm a doctor and I'm diagnosing various challenging cases and all. But this aspect of mine has been appreciated by many, like writing down a book is not an easy job. We struggle to write one page, and you have written some 150 pages book. It's a big, big achievement. And after reading the book also, I got very good reviews on that. So that has really, it'll help. It'll give you a motivation, actually, like I'm not getting any words, but it has got a positive impact on my health, I can say you. Yeah.
Great, great, great. When you first announced in your family and your friends that you have started writing a book, what was the reaction?
People will say, book to likhte rehte hain, and many people said, who will read your book? And who will buy your book? Like that, questions will come into mind. But I felt book writing is a process of meditation. It's one type of a meditation, because once you're sitting and you have to concentrate and write the content, you are totally not you. You are totally in a different mode of this thing. Like you have to put all your senses into place and you have to concentrate and write it down. So that experience, you know, forget about book writing and releasing the book and all. That experience has, I love that experience very much.
And now when your book is published and now when it is available in the market, people are reading it, they are sharing their review with you, they are sharing their feedback. How do you feel? What is the feeling?
It's a wow feeling, I can say you. I have written, just for my own sake, but when I'm getting the reviews and all, no, it really, you feel good about it. Every time you read individual review, no? So, yes, I feel good about it. That's what I can say.
And how's the family's reaction? When you said that you have written it mainly for your parents, when you gifted this book to them, or when you showed this book to them, what was their reaction?
My dad, he is not a book reader at all, but he has finished my book on time, you know, and he was traveling. When he was traveling, when he was going anywhere, he used to carry my book with him, you know, and wow. He used to show him, this is my daughter's book, and his English is a bit weak, but still he has completed my book, and he said, yes, you have written everything very well. I'm so proud of you.
Wow. So that's a very happy moment for you too.
Yes, yes, yes.
Okay, cool. Very nice. When you were writing your book, when you were in the middle of your writing journey, what kind of difficulties you face?
Difficulties not in the middle, but in the end, you know, when I have to end it. I have acknowledged many my mentors who have helped me from the school, my chairman sir, Mr. Pandrangareddy, and my college professors. And after my post-graduation, during my post-graduation, after post-graduation, many people have mentored me. Everybody were like step of a ladder.
Of course.
So, yeah, I was a bit worrying, like, can I mention their name when I have acknowledging them? So, will they feel offended or what? I exactly don't know, because this was my first experience. So, rest of the things were fine. So, because it's all like I've shared from a personal, professional experience. So, I have used their name without their consent. Also, is it okay? So, that was the worry which was I was about. Rest of the thing, it was fine actually.
Okay. And while you were writing, obviously, it was there in the mind that what you want to write, what you should be writing. What will be my first chapter? What will be my second chapter? That structure was obviously there in your mind. But did you learn anything during this entire process? Did your personality change in some ways?
Yes, I can say you. See, book writing, I told you, it's a type of meditative process. Any point of time you wanted to write a book, you will be going in a meditative mode for that much amount of time. That is an excellent gift given by you people.
Mm-hmm.
You. because unless I have joined the course, I would not have started writing the book. So you made us, it's like a small parents holding the child of a child's hand and taking them through the journey. It was simply, I feel the same, that you people are there behind us and making us go through that journey. So that one experience. And second experience, that writing skills, like how to write down, sit and write down. Many people are worried about that. But the super fast author, the voice typing skills, what you have taught us, really, really, even today, if anybody comes and they say, I have to type one page, I don't fear to type one page because I know the secret behind that. So Google voice typing, all those things, what you have taught us, really, it will make your work simple and focus on the main content rather than thinking about writing part and all those things, corrections and all. That will take care. Yeah.
So you agree that there is an importance to the role of a mentor?
Yes, yes. 100% I agree with that.
So if there is no mentor and if you are doing things on your own, then what will happen?
See, there is no time limit when you will finish your book. When will it go for proofreading? And when will it go for publishing? So nothing will go. It's something like a structured way of learning, I can say you. Like a schooling or a college where you have examinations on time to time and you'll pass out by so-and-so time. Similarly, if you are doing on independent, there is no time limit because we are not committed to ourselves to that I will finish the book within so much of specific time and all. So what attracted me towards super fast authors is super fast authors. Like how can you can write a book within 1 month? People take some age old days to, or maybe a year or more to write down books and all. But how we are able to write down a book within 30 days, it's that is a magic secret behind only you are having. Yeah.
So within how many days you wrote your book?
I think I completed in 25 days.
You completed it in 25 days. Wow. Yes. Impressive. Impressive. And do you think this formula is super powerful?
Yes. I recommend to majority of the people, they should go through like a super fast author or organization who are doing in a similar way. That will definitely help them in becoming an author and because rest of the team, you have a team who will take care of everything. So the only thing is that we need to devote our time and stay with you people and take the commands or whatever the instructions you are giving to us and go accordingly. Yeah.
Wow. Wow. So many people are writing their books. They are in the middle of their book writing journey currently. So do you have any words of wisdom for them? Any tips for them that don't do this kind of tips?
First is before starting the book, you should be sure what exactly you want to convey the message through your book and who are the target audience and what time limit you are giving for yourself, because this is an extra skill. Because as a personality, you have your professional commitments, personal commitments and other things to take care. So you will not be writing the book for a certain amount. So there should be some time limit for this. They have to set out that and don't think about writing it a voluminous book if you're venturing it out for the first time. Try to cut short it because all those will be taught in the Superfast author, curriculum, I can say you. Like if you're a first time author, you restrict your book to these many pages. If you're repeated author, whatever it is, you're releasing second, third or n number of books, then you can go. So as you gaining experience in this, you can increase the volume of your book. But if you're a beginner, yes, I say you should restrict yourself to some 20,000 words or something like that.
So should people write books? Not everyone is interested in writing book. Do you think it is necessary to write a book?
Yes. Why? Because as the science also say, no fingerprint match and no two different DNA matches.
Exactly. Similarly,
no two people stories will be alike. So every story is different. And the only aim of writing the book is that don't know, maybe in the whole world, if one person is also getting benefited out of this, we are saving one person.
If due to you, one person changes his life and you make a difference, your work is done.
Yes.
Okay, cool, cool, cool. So now, ma'am, when your book is out, now you are a published author, people are appreciating you, they're sharing their feedbacks with you. Do you have any plans of writing another book?
Yes, I have plans of, because in 2021 January, I have conducted a webinar on hematology. Mm-hmm. So then I was not well versed in this technical skills and all. So literally I have to struggle a lot bit. So people will say, why don't you do a webinar and all? But doing a webinar on your own takes a lot of efforts. So I just wanted to pen down my thoughts, my experience on webinar. I have started, but you know, I'm not in a structured way with a super fast author. So I couldn't, I would have joined again and I have to start.
We can help you with that. Don't worry. You just let us know what help you want and we will tell you how it can be done in the best possible way.
Maybe I have to rejoin for committing because in the group of authors that, what do you say, the environment itself is totally different.
You are in the group of like-minded people. Everyone is supporting each other. Everyone is motivating and encouraging each other. If you have a doubt and if you ask, there are people to give answers and different perspectives are offered. And then obviously you also feel like a special person there.
Yes.
So do you feel having a community of like-minded people helps?
Yes, it will always helps you in growing as an author. Like if you wanted to be author, you should be in a community of author, because you can take each other's help. I'm working in a hospital. If I'm with the other doctors, I will take each other's help. If I'm working with some non-doctor profession people, so it will not sink. So this is one type of a profession, I can say, how we are professional in individually. So authorship is also a profession. So we have to be associated with your own people.
Right. And like-minded people have a common goal. Everyone is talking about that common goal only. No time pass, no distractions. Everyone has a common goal. Of course, everyone's book is on different topic and different subject, but the goal is book.
Yes, but if you have, say, suppose I can share with other author, if I'm stuck somewhere, they can sense and they can guide you also. You're stuck in the end, stuck in the middle, or you're stuck with the proofreading, whatever it is, they can understand the language unspoken.
Very nice. So what's the difference between a person who has not written a book and a person who has written a book? So these two people are standing there. What's the difference you feel?
Yeah, I think, mainly we write the most of, not only me, many of the authors, they write the book to give some content to the society.
Correct.
Yeah. And if somebody is not becoming an author, you should take out time and find out the ways by at least, employing somebody for that job if you're not able to do that. But definitely you should convey the message to the society by, in a small way also it is okay, but at least try to do that, I can say you. Yes. Because it will help you yourself more than to the community. Because you will evolve as a person once you become an author. You are in sync with yourself, your discipline, and you're focused, and a lot of positive effects. That's why you could get so much of positive vibe from the reader side also.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay. Very nice. Ma'am, now a big question. When you decide to publish your book, your writing journey is over. Now you have decided to publish your book. What you should look for in a publisher before deciding your publisher? This is basically your advice to everyone who is writing a book. So what they should look for?
See, authenticated publisher should be there. But of course, we are associated with the super first authors. All those things were taken care by you people. So we were concentrating only on writing part.
So work with a professional.
So that was a journey made smooth. We need not worry about because you are there to take a decision on our behalf and guide us better way. Like, these are the ones which are available and all. So, and we have trusted you. And that's how you have made us successful.
Wow. Anything more you want to share from your side? My questions are almost over. Anything more from your side? You want to share something?
See, it's a once in a lifetime experience writing a book. People who try to write most of the time at the end of their career or end of the age. But I feel you should start writing before and share your experiences and everything, because book will not fake anything. You cannot write which is fake in the book. So
exactly.
Whatever the writing in the book is all truth. So let it be an experience or any other content or anything. So I feel starting from the small subject to any big subject, depending on the expertise what you have and what amount of exposure you have towards that subject and all, you should choose to write it down or pen it down. Or otherwise, if you have only very small stories, get clubbed with other authors and make a conglomeration of stories, like and you can release. But you should speak out. And
dil ke andar mat rakho baat. Dil ke andar mat rakho. Bahar nikalo.
Bahar nikalo ne sabko batao. Kyunki jab tak hum bolenge nahi, so other people. अरे ये तो मेरे साथ भी हुआ था. अच्छा, तो ये ऑथर ने ऐसे किया है तो मैं भी ऐसे कर सकती हूँ. सो दैट मैसेज शुड गो ऑन टू द
मैसेज शुड गो ऑन. लेट्स चेंज लाइव्स. लेट्स हेल्प अदर्स आल्सो टू लर्न फ्रॉम आवर मिस्टेक्स. मे बी लेट देम आल्सो फाइंड देयर वेज एंड लेट देयर लाइव्स बी आल्सो चेंज्ड. ग्रेट. सो थैंक यू. यू आर सेइंग समथिंग मैम.
Yeah, especially for the female authors who are busy moms like me, handling the personal as well as the professional life. So they will think, mujhe to bachchon ke saath time hi nahi milta hai.
Right.
Office ja ke karti hu. So these are all excuses, I feel. Once you have decided that you should pen down your thoughts, you should go ahead with that. So gender should not stop you from achieving anything. So when it comes to the author, he or she is an author. So that should get erased from the mind, and age is not at all the criteria.
Exactly. Age, qualification, gender should not be a criteria.
Yeah. So that should not be a criteria, and you should, once you have decided, you should pen down. If you are able to do it on your own, it's well and good. But if you are not able to do it on your own, please take help of the structured programmers and the people who are there, just like super fast authors. That will definitely it's once a lifetime experience. You should definitely go with them and enjoy the journey with them. Kailash sir is not there now, like, to speak about, but excellent journey with him. He will mentor you and he will support you, like anything. And same time, Deepak sir will take care the rest of the part. Once your book is ready and it's ready to get published and all, he will of the rest of the things, and he will guide you accordingly. So you feel home working these people, and so it's very good to get associated with you people. And please, if anybody have a step back, please come forward and join us and become a successful author.
Wow.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you. We always say that everyone has a story. Everyone has a story to share. Have you shared yours? We all have different experiences. We all have different, faced many challenges. Everyone was different. Everyone's life was challenging. But we are what we are after conquering those mountains. So we have reached to this level after taking many steps. few were right, few were wrong, but yes, we could achieve what we could. So everyone has a story. Everyone must share their story so that they can change lives, they can motivate others, and they can make an impact.
Yes, yes. Sir, so, one more thing I wanted to add is,
please.
Whatever the negative setbacks you get in your life, try to take it in a positive way. That is the main aim of, I think, any author wanted to convey. Because all those are that sharpening tools which come in your life to sharpen you. So you should get sharp and go ahead, not get hooked up in that and sink yourself.
Exactly. So that is, don't get demotivated. Learn from your own mistakes. Learn from the mistakes of others. Take the right message. Use it powerfully and perfectly in your life so that you move ahead and you become successful in your life.
So make friendship with the books and stay positive forever. Books will never make you feel bad or whatever. It will always make you feel good because there's a lot of positivity involved with all the authors who are releasing the book in the public domain. So that's what, yeah.
Wow. Fantastic message, man. Lovely.
Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you so much. We have reached to the end of our today's interview. Thank you very much, ma'am, for joining today, for taking time out from your busy schedule, spending time with us where you could share your thoughts, your journey, your message. It was lovely, lovely talking to you. We always knew that you are one amazing personality, and today also you proved it again. So thank you very much for enlightening us. Thank you for joining us today.
Thank you so much, sir, for giving this opportunity, for getting associated with you. Thank you for the opportunity.
Thank you, ma'am. God bless you. God bless you in your upcoming endeavors.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, ma'am. Take care.